morning.
Electronica, my name is Thomas. I'm an engineer, one of the co-founders at ICECAP Systems. ICECAP Systems is a spin-off from the University of Malta, specializing in active thermal management solutions, specifically microscale cooling. Now, we all know that active thermal management can be a bit of a hot topic, right? Pun intended. It can be very challenging, and we all want our devices to be cool and reliable. After the end of the day, we want our customers to be happy. And part of that is it can be very challenging, no? It's not easy to make sure that our embedded devices are kept nice, cool, and reliable. And oftentimes in these discussions, we discuss, you know, compressor-based systems. And while they're often the answer for many things, given their efficiency, they are not always feasible. Their construction and size aren't the right fit for every product. And often in this discussion is where thermoelectric or Peltier cooling comes into play. And Peltier cooling has been around for a while, right? And it has some great advantages. Gives you temperature difference through a purely solid state approach. They're compact, silent, sustainable, and oftentimes we can even stack them on top of each other to create these multi-stage coolers, which give you even more, an even larger temperature difference. However, as interesting as Peltier coolers are for many applications, they're actually even sophisticated applications, you know, in photonics, lasers, medical devices. They are plagued by a curse. They are extremely inefficient sometimes, especially when you really drive them to those deep temperature differences. And especially multi-stage coolers. Multi-stage coolers struggle from complex modeling. They struggle with environmental changes, with change already the modeling you tried so hard to get right. And inadequate isolation of these multi-stage coolers to electronic devices can make your life even harder. And we ran into this problem ourselves when trying to design thermoelectric cooling for our very portable, small form factor products. So we decided to just come up with a solution ourselves. And that's where we come in. Where is our innovation? Our innovation lies in two ways. We have a patent on a superior control method to optimize the efficiency of multi-stage coolers. We also have a patent on how to innovate the thermal isolation of electronic components from these multi-stage coolers. And together, what we're trying to achieve with this is to enhance the feasibility of multi-stage coolers for deep cooling applications. So we really want, where before, thermoelectric cooling would be a perfect fit in very portable products, and your battery would always be the bottleneck since your thermoelectric setup is consuming so much power. Now we're unlocking that possibility. Our technology gives you all the great things about Peltiers, that they're compact, they're accurate, they're sustainable, and they're reliable. But we're doubling down on trying to get that efficiency right. We really want this technology that many people have struck off to be actually feasible for portable products. And our optimization algorithm actually right now gives us up to 20% improvements in multi-stage cooler efficiency. And our thermal isolation techniques can give you a 10% reduction in thermal leakage. And so we have the IP, right? How do we deliver this IP to our customers in a really useful and convenient way? And that's where our first product comes in, the aerostat controller. The aerostat controller is the first of its kind quad Peltier controller specifically designed for multi-stage coolers. Here, we're trying to make the process as simple as possible for you to set up, test, and prototype your multi-stage thermoelectric cooling setups. And it also comes pre-packaged with our IP. So it has the optimization algorithm in it already. So you have all the benefits of our technology in a convenient controller. It's as simple as setting up your system, booting up our PC software, and finding your device. Once you found your device, you configure your multi-stage cooling setup with the required, you know, boring details such as heat pumping capacity, temperature difference, etc. And once you're ready to go, you simply go to the dashboard and monitor your system. Here you can set the required set point temperature you need and let the controller do the rest. Here, telemetry and monitoring can be essential for you to get the data you need to characterize your system or perhaps create a benchtop setup for cooling. We really want to make sure that whoever wants to implement multi-stage Peltier cooling gets it right the first time. We want to take the guesswork out of something that's on paper looks so complex and make it as simple as possible. And we've been using this setup ourselves, actually. We had an application, for example, a high-speed imaging camera, where we needed to cool a CMOS image sensor below ambient to improve its noise performance. We're tasked with designing the thermoelectric cooling and thermal management of the setup, and our technology here was a perfect fit, right? Imagine designing a high-speed camera in Malta, where in summer it's 40 degrees Celsius outside. I can assure you, taking the high-speed camera outside, it will not be happy. Neither was I, to be fair. But that's where optimization algorithm really shines. It knows when the ambient conditions have changed and will adjust accordingly to give you the best efficiency possible in those conditions. We also have an in-house right now application where we're taking, so we say now, multi-stage cooling is feasible now for something like medical transportation. Last mile cold chain, for example, this is where Peltiers can really shine. A portable, efficient way to take medical products to the last mile of their destination. Here, where before a battery-operated setup would not be feasible using Peltier systems, we can make it possible using our optimization algorithm, especially since such a last-mile device would be taken outside, changes in ambient, changes in heat load. That's where the optimization algorithm kicks in and takes care of everything for you. And where do we see ICECAP systems going beyond this? We have big plans to ensure, or rather, we want to make our customers as easy as possible for them to get to market as quickly as possible when they're using thermoelectric cooling. So beyond the aerostat controller, we'd also like to expand our core product offering with, for example, validated thermoelectric stacks, right? Take the guesswork out of sizing your thermoelectric modules, and we'll just give you a pre-validated stack ready to go. Hermetic packages, for example, ready to cool your electronic components on your devices. And companion heat sinks, because whoever is into thermal management knows that your cooling is only good as your thermal dissipation, right? And we don't want to make your lovely design go to waste because you have an inefficient heatsink, for example. So we'll give you the optimal heatsink in that form factor. And that will form part of our core product offering. And in the future, we hope to include this also application-specific product, but also service systems, right? While the aerostat controllers can't be put into every product, we can integrate the ICECAP core IP into someone else's product in a small and miniature way. Here today, we have the aerostat controller as well as the camera that I mentioned earlier on our booth, and we'll be more than happy to show it to you and discuss the opportunities there are with such multi-stage thermoelectric cooling. And of course, we're more than happy to take any questions and hope I'll see you on our stand later. So thank you very much. And thank you again to Elektor for the opportunity. Cute.
So with that, I'm very excited to announce our third placed winner of our Fast Forward Award this year. In third place, with a marketing budget of 10,000 euros from Elektor, we have the ICECAP team. So congratulations. Please come up to the board, up to the stage here. And we have a very special person who's going to come and present the award. This is Isabel Obieta Villalonga from the European Innovation Council. If I can just invite you up for a second. We're talking here about innovation. We're talking here about startups. Why is this award and having these people here doing something like this so important to Europe?
It is, absolutely, yeah. We know where we are. We know that competitiveness now is the next word for the European Commission. So startup world, innovation, and bringing the innovation to the market, this is exactly what the European Innovation Council was created for. And also helping in this journey, because we know that it's difficult. It's not always an easy path. So that was created exactly for that. Europe is very strong in research. Everybody knows that we are really failing in bringing this to innovation if we compare ourselves with other countries. So this was exactly the aim of the European Innovation Council. So I think it's great that you are able to create this community, this environment that will help them in bringing everything forward. And I'm really glad to be here. And let's see if we can support them even further. We were discussing yesterday that maybe our programs are also adapted to them. So let's see if we can build all this together, this momentum.
And maybe for those people who've never interacted with the European Innovation Council, I know here in Bavaria we have lots of support and financial support. How does it trickle down from European level, and where can people find out about those programs and innovation
activities?
Yeah,
indeed. Well, we have our website, of course. The European Innovation Council is part of Horizon Europe big framework research program. We are the Pillar 3, which is Innovative Europe, I think it's called. But if you really want some advice, you have your national contact points everywhere. In the regional national contact point here is quite strong. Else, you can also reach out to me. And well, everything is online and everything is on the website. But I would be glad to help you if this is needed. Yeah.
Fantastic, Isabel. Thank you ever so much. You can give me the microphone if we just take you over here. You can pass on the check to the team, and we'll have a photo. And round of applause. So if everyone can look forward to the cameraman here at the front, please.